Yo, what up? It's Chris back with another video. And today what I want to talk about is how do you get the results you want when you're going and you're meeting people? Now, here's the thing. I'm going to first and foremost say this. I naturally, when I was like younger, I was very like stick to the rules. I listened to what my parents said. I listened to what the teachers say. I listened to what my pastor said. I was very much like not my own person. I felt like looking back, I felt like a robot. I felt like, yeah, I was a good person, but I wasn't doing what I wanted to do. I was doing and living my life for what other people wanted me to do. And that's no way to live. You have to live for you. Whatever your calling is in your life and whatever your passions are, whatever, you know, the accumulation of everything that you have that makes you who you are, that's how you live your life. And so one thing for me, I always would see people that are very, you know, confident and they could just go up and talk to people and, you know, they get a bunch of girls or they do this and et cetera, things like that. I'm always like, how do they do that? I don't understand. I don't get it. Like, I'm a nice guy. Like, I would watch like Disney movies and I'd be like, oh yeah, I just need to like find a girl. She drops her glass slipper and then that'll be my wife. I remember I used to think I was like, oh, I just want a girl. I had like a 2006 Ford Escape. That was my first car. And I was like, if I could just have a girl sit right next to me here in the passenger seat, my life would be complete. That was when I was like 18 years old, right? And so here's the thing, like that mindset that I had, that it couldn't be me, that I just like, it was very much like, oh, I just need this thing and I can just be super nice, da 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 da. And I would see like another guy in school, like he'd like smack a girl's ass and I'd be like, he shouldn't be doing that. And then like she laughs and I'm like, why is she laughing? There's like these little things that always confused me because like what I was taught is good and what's bad, it wasn't necessarily like that. And I'm not saying smack a girl's ass, like, but what I'm saying is it blew my mind that he did that and she loved it. It just didn't make sense because that wasn't in my reality, you know, at that age, 17, 18. Anyway, fast forward to today. I went out last night and absolutely crushed, right? This is, you know, I've been going out for years and I absolutely crushed. And when I first get in, and this is me going out completely sober, right? So when I first go out, My goal is just to get into a good mood, right? I'm already on the way there. I'm listening to some music. I'm riding with one of my homies and we're listening to music. We're talking, we're chatting it up. That's like my goal, is just to build my vibe up. So when I go out into this environment, the environment doesn't absolutely destroy me because there's going to be people that are drunk. The music's going to be loud. Someone's going to spill a drink on me. Actually, last night I sat in gum and like a girl like was like picking it off my butt. And I was like, yo, why are you touching my butt? And like, she was like, oh, you have gum on there. I was trying to get it off for you. And like, it's, things are gonna happen when you go out. Like, you cannot control the randomness of the night, but what you can is you can get ahead of it by getting in a good mood. And when you're in a good mood, the bar is so low that you're actually gonna be able to take over the entire venue. You're gonna be able to win and absolutely dominate. And that's exactly what I did last night. So my night started out, I got inside. First person I see was a guy I went to high school with. I'm, yo, what's up, bro? Good to see you. We chatted up for a second and I move on to the next person. And that's what I'm gonna do throughout the night. I'm gonna move from person to person to person to person, person to person to person to person. I'm gonna talk to as many people as I possibly can and just have fun. I'm gonna be joking around. We're gonna be jumping up and down. We're gonna be screaming. One thing that stuck out last night was like, I met a girl who, it was actually a group of girls. It was like a table of like 8 or 9 girls and they were all just screaming. There's this trend going around. If you know Kai Cenat, then you probably know the trend, or if you're on TikTok, you've probably seen it. It's like, give me my money. So like the trend essentially is someone says, give me my money. And then everybody starts cheering for him. Yay. And then like at the end, whoever the person you're trying to trick, you say, give me my money. And then like they say it and then nobody cheers. So it's like this, it's just a trick, but essentially they were just cheering for everybody. And I was like, yo, the vibe is fucking sick. This table, like 8 chicks. They're like, give me my money. Then the whole crowd cheers. Everybody in the bar is looking. It's like an outside bar mixed with inside. Everybody's looking at them. They have all the attention. And so I'm like, I feel there. I'm watching. I'm like, oh shoot, they got energy. So what do? I instantly run over there. I'm like, give me my money. And then they all start cheering. Woo! And it becomes a whole thing. Now this is what's crazy, because after I did that, and I build the vibe, there was a girl looking at me, one of the 8 girls, and she was like, come here. And I'm like, no, you come here. And she's like, no, come. So I go over there and she's like, oh my God, do you have a girlfriend? First thing she said off rip, do you have a girlfriend? I'm like, no, we chatted for a few minutes. Really nothing came of it, but it doesn't matter. I'm just having fun in the night and we're vibing. I move to the next table. Now this next table I move to, they're not liking the girls behind us. It's like a group of 4 girls and they don't like the 8 girls. I'm like, yo, give me my money. And then they're just like, no, we're not gonna give you our money. Like they're very like low energy, like not trying to have fun. They're at the bar, just them 4 looking bored as shit. And you can tell, you can see this energy, right? And I just start trying to vibe with them, but they're, you know, they're not really feeling it. They're like, yeah, like those girls are being so loud. Da, da, da. I'm like, you know what? I'm going to tell them to be quiet. Don't you worry. So I go up to the next, I go back up to that first table with the eight girls. And then I'm like, hey, give me my money. Then they're like, ah, everybody cheers. And the girls at the table just look like, ah, they're just mad. And they're nice, whatever. But it's like, life is not serious, right? The thing is, when we go out, and when people are drinking and they're doing their drugs, or even if they're sober and they're just standing in the corner, just watching everyone else, it's like, what are we doing? This is your time. This is our life. When are we gonna actually enjoy it? It's like, one day I'll be this and one day I'll be that. No, it starts right now. It starts today. It starts right this very second you're watching this video. This is when it starts. This is when you win. And it's so easy to project our lives into the future. That's what I used to do. I used to say, oh, well, one day I'll find the girl who will sit next to me in the in my car seat in my 06 Ford Escape. It's like, yo, go get her today. I should be like, if I see a girl that's cute, you should go talk to her right then and there. And that's what we do when you're a winner. When you're a winner, you just go and you talk and you go do it right then and there. You don't hesitate. You don't wait. You just go. And that's what that night was. Last night, it was just me going up, messing around. There's like, they have like this weird little bathtub at the bar that we go to. And literally, I'm just like, these girls are like, oh, let's sit in the bathtub. I'm like, yeah, sit in the bathtub. I'll take pictures, y'all. And I'm taking pictures of them. And we're just vibing. It's just a vibe. We make it so hard. We're trying to look cool. Oh, I'm cool. You know what I mean? Oh, I'm in the gym. Like, oh, shit. You know, I got my drink in my hand. I'm drinking my drink, whatever. Yo, what's up, girl? Hey, what's good? No, be an idiot. Be an absolute idiot. Because here's the thing. I used to think, like, being cool, like looking cool and being cool was the thing, right? But it's like, wait a minute. You know what's actually cool? Having so much fucking fun that you fucking will just fucking throw up. It's not drunk, by the way. I'm not saying throw up because you're drunk. I'm saying it's just so much fucking fun you can't even fucking handle it. It's just so much shit. Because what happened last night for me is like, when I get into that rhythm and just go and go and go and talk and talk and don't think, don't overthink it. Don't be like, oh, what am I gonna say? I just say whatever the fuck comes to my mind. I remember one of the girls that I tapped on the shoulder, and the guy came up to me later. I go up, tap her on the shoulder, and I'm like, hey, on a scale of 1 to 10, what's your favorite number? That didn't even make any sense what I said. But that's what I fucking, and she was like, 5. And I'm like, why 5? And she's like, I don't know, 5 is just a good number. And I'm like, I need a better answer than that. Why do you like 5? Like, what is it about 5? And like, that was it. Like, it's just like, it was just a moment we had. And that's it was an attractive girl. And it's just a moment. It's like, people think, oh, well, I'm not, you know, dating her now, so the interaction's ruined. No, you can always go back up. It's never over. There's been plenty of girls that I've talked to before, and we talked, then it ended very quickly. And then like weeks later, days later, an hour later, a minute later, I go back up to them and we talk again. And then we hit it off perfectly. It's like, what are we so scared of? What are we so worried about? Life is simple if you keep it simple. Life is hard if you make it hard. Like, I'm out here and it's like, just make the video, dude. Who cares about the cars driving by or the people staring behind? It's like, just make the video. It's simple. Don't think. We think too much. We're thinking about shit that doesn't fucking matter. You know what you should be thinking about? How much fucking fun can I have? And the shit just works out. Like, I ended up, the end of my night, I ended up meeting a girl I've actually seen a couple times. We never hung out. And last night we hung out and we had a great time together. And it's like, you don't have to just, I went up to her and now I need to get her. No, bro. Like, are you that desperate, bro? That every time you go and talk to a girl, you need to get that girl? No, bro. Go have fun with everybody. Guys, girls, the fucking animals. They got fucking, bro, stand next to the fucking water and have, like, when I'm holding and like drinking a cold thing of water at this place, because they have the coldest water in our city, by the way. It's like on tap, you just like, whatever, hold the thing. In the little Gatorade containers. I drink this water, I'm like, this water's so good. Like, just in the moment, bro. And when you have that much fun, you'll have girls coming up to you. I had a girl come up to me, she's like, yeah, let me get your number. Off rip. And the thing is, we could go super like mystical about it. Like, why did she do that? Because I was feeling so good at this point, right? Was it because she saw me because of all the give me my money? Was it because of the give me my money moment? Was it just the energy I was giving in the moment? Who knows, who cares? But you know what I do care about? I'm going to have fucking fun. I'm not going to try to look cool. I'm not going to give a fuck what anybody thinks. I am going to literally just be a fucking idiot and just have so much fucking fun. And if I see someone I like, I'm going to go talk to them. It's simple. We make it hard. Oh, I need to do this, and I need to walk up like this, and I need to do that. You, dude, life is too random to even think like that. Just go up and say what's up. It's simple. So if you want the best life possible, that's where you start. Like, if you feel like you're at a point in your life where you don't know how to talk to people and you don't know how to be yourself, essentially, you know how when you're talking to your friends and you can just be yourself, you can say whatever, you just like, oh, I'm good. That's how you should feel all the time with everybody you meet. All that is you're just comfortable with yourself, and it accentuates out. That's all that is. When you can talk to your friends like, oh, I say whatever to my friends, da, 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 I don't care. That's because you know them and you know they value your opinion. Y'all agree on some things, y'all don't agree on others, but it's okay because you know they're not going to kill you, right? But you feel like these random strangers you meet will kill you if you say the wrong thing. Who cares? Your intentions are not to hurt anybody's feelings, right? So say how you feel. Say what you want. Life is fucking amazing if you let it be. If you let it be amazing, it's amazing. But if you're trying too hard to get approval from others, or you don't want to say the wrong thing, that's where you get stuck in this fucking thing. You don't need it. When you're talking to people, you don't need this. Just free associate. Like, this whole video is not planned. I wasn't thinking about this. We're 11 minutes in. I was not thinking, oh, well, what exactly do I need to say? I have a script here. Let me read this line, subsection B, article 2. Bro, just spit game, bro. Just talk the shit. Just chop it up. Just have fun. Bada boom, bada bing. But yeah, more videos on the way. I'm going to start doing some videos where y'all can actually see me talking out. I think I should do that. I think that might help, just to see how a night goes when you're just having fun and shit. Yeah, so we'll see you in the next video. I love you boys and gals, of course. And yeah, I'll see y'all in the next one. Peace.